is Dr. Men. I'm Bright on the DMSI YouTube channel. Now, today I want to say something that was trending some time ago on most social media platforms. All right, someone came online to talk about how she's had 28 abortions in about 9 years. Right? Yes, 28 abortions in 9 years. So I was actually wondering if we are doing money rituals with the pregnancies. Okay. All right. So there was this question about whether or not that was possible. Well, I'm not here to say whether or not it's possible to have 28 abortions, but candidly speaking, why should you want to try to have 28 abortions in the first place? So I'm going to take us through a practical guide on how not to get pregnant when you're not ready, or when you're not prepared, when you don't need it, when it's going to end in an abortion. Okay, so you come with me. Now, I want to mention right here that it takes two to tango. You already know that because pregnancy requires two persons, it's wrong for us as kings that you are to think that, oh, this is something for the queens or for ladies and so on and so forth. Okay, now it will be responsible of you that has a spouse who also wants to or not wants not to get pregnant to also understand how best and their plan how not to get pregnant when it's not required yet. There's nobody, and I repeat, nobody actually should bring a baby to this world unprepared or planned. It takes a lot to raise children, and we all know that. All right, so but you also don't want to be doing abortions every month or every 4 months, every 3 months, whatever the case may be, because that it has to be like that for you to be able to have 28 abortions, you know what I mean? So now the woman's cycle, all right, begins and ends with bleeding. All right, what I'm saying is there are fundamental things that you need to understand, be it as a woman or as a man, for you to be able to plan around your menstrual cycle and to see that you don't get pregnant or you don't need it. And one of these things is the menstrual cycle. Now, I need you to understand the concept of the menstrual cycle, because a lot of the things I'm talking about is surrounding the understanding of the menstrual cycle. That's what will help you to determine when to make out and when not to make out. All right? Now, as common as it may be, I've realized that a lot of people still do not understand when they talk about last menstrual period, and then when they talk about menstrual period, or when they talk about menstrual cycle. So we'll be talking about these terms, and then hopefully by the end of it, we'll be able to, when we understand these things, we can move forward to now understand and be able to prevent getting pregnant when it's not needed, all right? So now, let me begin by the last menstrual period. Usually, the last menstrual period of a female, all right, of course, it has to be of a female now. Guys don't have menstrual period, right? So your last menstrual period is the day that blood begins, that you start seeing blood. That's the first day of a menstrual, of the menstrual period, all right? Now, the flow could be for 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, 6 days, or that's about the longest. Some persons will have flow for up to like 7 days, okay? Now, the menstrual cycle is the day that you first saw blood, which is the first day of this menstrual period, of seeing menses, of menstruation, to the first day of another cycle. That's the menstrual cycle, all right? So if 1st of March, if you saw blood on 1st of March, and then you are seeing blood again on the 28th of March or the 29th of March, it therefore means that the menstrual cycle is from 1st of March to 29th of March, and that means your menstrual cycle is, you have a 28 days menstrual cycle. Now, the menstrual cycle differ from individual to individual. Even in one person, it may also differ. So sometimes you could have a 28-day cycle, and some other times the cycle could be 29 days, some other times 30, and so on and so forth. But over time, you will come to understand, because it's important that you understand what your menstrual cycle actually is, how many days is your menstrual cycle. This is very key, because if you do not understand how many days or what the length of your menstrual cycle is, it's going to be very difficult for you to be able to plan around when you can make out and when you will be pregnant or when you will not be pregnant. So I hope that is quite clear. The first day of the menstrual, or the first day that you saw blood, or the first day that she saw blood, to when she sees blood again, is the menstrual cycle. So it could be 28 days, it could be as short as 24 days, it could be as long as 38 days, 39 days, sometimes, all right? So it is when it is shorter than 23 days or 24, 23 days, or when it's longer than 38, 39 days, that we think that you may say that it's a problem. What's most important, really, is not whether or not it comes on the same day. What is most important is the fact that it is regular. Regular means it comes every month. All right? So that's the menstrual cycle. I hope we get that. Now, there are two key factors that we must also understand for us to be able to know that this is what we should do and this is what we should not do, or when we should do or we should not do it. Now, those two factors are the gametes. When I say gametes, you know, it takes, like we said before, it takes two to form a baby. The woman produces a gamete, all right, that we call the ovum, as well as the man also produces the sperm cell, all right, or the sperm gamete. Now, the lifespan of these two things, the lifespan, when I say lifespan, of course, I mean how long they will be around before they get decimated, before they die off, or also, you also need to understand that. But before we go into that, let's first understand when it is most likely that a woman is or a female will be releasing an egg, what we call ovulation, all right? So normally, mid into the cycle, it is expected that most women will release an egg. When I say mid into the cycle, that's mid into the cycle. I'm talking about for a 28-day cycle, we're looking at the 15th day from the first day of the menstrual cycle. For a 30-day cycle, probably looking at the 16th day. For a 32-day cycle, probably looking at the 16th day or the 17th day. For a 38-day cycle, we're looking at about the 19th day, and so on and so forth. So mid into your cycle, into the menstrual cycle, it's expected that an egg, it's usually one egg most times, is going to be available for fertilization, what you call fertilization, that precedes the formation of a baby, all right? Now, having known that, we would come back to the lifespan of what's produced by the male and the female. And this is really very important, okay? So, the sperm cell will last 6 days normally, having been released, having been produced. It usually will be around for 6 days before it gets decimated or it dies off, all right? And then for the ovum, or the female cell that forms part of the baby, it will last only 24 hours. Mark it, please, it's important that it will last only 24 hours. Now, what this means is if the pain that you did 5 days ago, all right, the day that you did it inclusive, or 6 days ago, the day that you 5 days ago, or 6 days ago, inclusive of the day that you did it, is still capable of being crammed, all right, or of forming a baby to an egg that's released, all right, 6 days or 5 days after a sexual intercourse had occurred. It's what I hope you understand that. All right, so the sperm, so there is a 6 days window within which you are likely, or the female, your spouse or yourself is likely to get pregnant, and that's the 6 day cycle. So you have 6 days that the sperm cell usually will survive for, and then you have the 1 day that the egg will survive for, all right? So remember that the reason why it's still 6 days but not 7 days is because the egg, all right, the 6 days of the sperm is inclusive, or the 1 day of the ova is inclusive in the 6 day of the sperm. So we'll take, for example, let's get practical now. If sexual intercourse is had, or if egg is released midway to the cycle, and we call the day that the egg is released as day X, for example, all right, what this means is that the sexual intercourse that was had 5 days before the X is still capable of forming a zygote, and then that further will progress to a baby. I think that's quite practical enough. So any from 6 days before, that's 5 days before sexual intercourse, all right, or from 5 days before when egg is released, it's still very possible that whatever is done on the 5 days, 6 days, 4 days, 3rd day, 2nd day, 1st day, all right, and eventually the read day is capable of being crowned a king, or getting to form a zygote that eventually form a baby. Now, the sperm cell lasts 6 days and the egg lasts for only 24 hours. So what that means is that if the egg also is released, all right, on the 6th day, all right, after this sexual intercourse, by the 7th day, which is the next day, usually the egg would have died. So the sperm that was released 6 days before that day is not likely to be able to fertilize an egg even a day after the egg is released. So this is, if you master this plan and you are able to work around it, it is not likely that you'll be having to do 28 abortions, even in a lifetime. It is not likely that you'll be caught up in a scenario where you are trying to, where you are worried that you're about to bring a baby to this world that you really did not plan for. All right, so this is it. I hope it's practical enough. But if there are reasons why anybody think that we should, there's something we need to still talk about as far as this is concerned, we do hope that we're able to do a lot more videos. If you have watched this and you've learned, make sure you like it, keep sharing it so that others will watch. Make sure you invite a friend to subscribe to our channel, and then subscribe to this channel yourself, as we promise to be doing lots and lots of educative videos that will be impactful, and then you'll never regret that you did.